Bamumeya.
Listen. A call was made by Dumelo. The first call when his friends were shot. What Dumelo, a boyfriend, Kazandi, of which he didn't know by name, a shot was sent, and then a phone was dropped. At the background, Ukeli, she was crying, got on the tree, Nigu Magasenzo. And that information was given to the SAPS. Ukuthi why they do not want to arrest.
I saw a comment. Somebody says, lying is for smart people. Let me repeat. Lying is for smart people. I didn't say anything, but I'm about to say something, right? Togozisi said he was tortured by police, right? He's a friend to Mandisa. He was a friend to Lokusenzo Meyiwa. Togozisi was involved in the day, or look, he was there in the day of the incident. Togozisi also knew that Senzo Meyiwa was shot, and Togozisi knew as well that Senzo Meyiwa was died on the way to hospital. Wait a minute. Did I say something? Did I forget something? Not to mention the fact that the same Togozisi tells us that he slept in the same house with Zandi Khumalo. Then it was Zandi Khumalo, it was Togozisi Twala, it was Senzo Meyiwa, and it was Kelly Khumalo. Wait a minute, did I forget this? Not to mention the fact that the same Togozisi Twala told us something, and you know what he said. He said that, you know what? The thing that said Bona knows, no, look, Bona, they went to, first of all, he was drinking different type of alcohol. And then Zandi Khumalo talks about Guarana. You know what I'm saying? Do you remember the party? You know what I'm saying? They went to the party and he says, nope, that did not happen. Wait a minute. Not to mention the fact that the man, he seems to be discrediting everything that Zandi Khumalo said. Wait a minute. Am I getting things correct here or not? Well, wait. Before you jump into a conclusion and you say what I did not say. I did not say the man is lying, but I'm saying the man is not telling the truth. Or he's telling the truth, but you know what I'm saying? Sometimes it's not telling the truth. Aha! That is what I was saying. But again, I'm about to unpack all of those things, provided that you are interested. If you are interested, then please stick around. As you stick around, I put it to you that you subscribe, you like the video, and you comment in the comment section below. I put it to you that you click the like button. You know the like button, you know what I'm saying? Click that like button. It tells the algorithm to say, people like the video. Hey, YouTube, please promote this video to more people so we can get more videos to 100,000, guys. When you comment, it tells the algorithm to say, hey, people are commenting and engaging in this video. Therefore, promote this video to more people. Number three, if you watch this video close to the end, it tells the algorithm to say, hey, people are watching it longer. It is worth promoting. So then our video can get to even 1 million views. So the power is in your hands. One last power that is in your hands. If you wish to contribute financially to this YouTube channel, well, the simplest and the easiest, and it's free. Watch as many ads as possible. That's the best way you can support this channel. That's the best way for you to support this YouTube channel. Speaking about this being the best way for you to support and promote this YouTube channel. Ay! Was it not Dumelo? Is it not Dumelo? Oh, so Dumelo, come out of my mouth. Hey, Togozisi takes a stand and then tells us this thing. The first thing that I noticed, these things are in no chronological order. Allow me to go into those things, right? He says that he wanted to get out of that place, police station, get to a safer place with the people he know where he will feel safe. If these people will assault me like this, wanting me to admit to a crime that I know nothing about, they are capable of killing me. First of all, right there, it's an admission that, wait a minute, he is a suspect. Quite interesting. Does that say something about docket number two that says everybody that was in that house or at that house, he's a suspect? Does it say anything about that? Your mind says something. When you choose friends next time, please remember to choose friends correctly, because you see what friends are doing right now. Are you happy about it?
No, you're not happy, right? I know. Instead of them coming here, defending their friend, but they are coming here to make sure that their friend is not getting justice. But I like Mthokozi Thwala. Because Mthokozi Thwala, it seems like somehow he did not get the memo. The public figure did not help Mthokozi Thwala to correct his things so the story can collaborate. He seems to be diverting from what the public figure said. Remember the public figure said they bought what? Guarana. Do you remember that? Well, speaking about Guarana, the public figure said that she's the one that popped around 400 and something and she got some change there. Do you remember that one? Do you remember that in the crime scene, the photos that they got was... Remember that at the crime scene, the type of alcohol that was recorded in there was 2 cans of Guarana. And I said it, that there is something wrong about this. Now it makes sense that Mapiri cleaned the crime scene. Mapiri must go down to prison. You know what I'm saying, that? I knew that you are so smart, you will figure it out. You know why? Because Mthokozi says yena, he was drinking Hunters. Where in the crime scene do you get bottles of one or cans of Hunters? I'm listening. Because some are saying, you have already taken a side. Man, listen. May I listen with my ears and I watch with my eyes. I have been following the consistency therein. And it's impossible for me just to give an analysis that does not take side. Here, I'm going to tell you straightforward. I don't trust everybody that was in that house. No, never. I don't trust everybody that was in that house. I don't care what people are saying. I don't trust them all. Because there's just one truth that they are not telling us. They should have just said, come out and say, this is the person that killed the person. That's it. Stop telling us the fake story of intruders because we can see it is fabricated. You know what I'm saying? So you expecting me to just take side with this fabricated lies? No, I'm not. There's a man telling us he was drinking Hunters. Never this Guarana thing. Chances are Senzo Meyiwa was drinking a different type of alcohol. That is not them. So clearly the crime scene was tampered with purposefully and deliberately. So clearly the public figure lied. Public figure being Zandile Khumalo. Now you see where I'm going. So before we transition into the next point, hey, I saw people from Namibia into my comment. You know what I'm saying? It was nice seeing you guys, and I appreciate you taking time and watching my videos. I know there are people from UK. I know there are people from Israel. I know there are people from Swaziland. I know there are people from Botswana. I know there are people from, I forgot other countries as well, but these are the countries that comes to my mind. Namibia, I'm going to leave my people from Namibia. I might visit you. I'm going to be doing my book tour anytime soon. In fact, before December, I would have been in Kenya. I'll go to Kenya. Then December, I'll be in Swaziland, right? To those that don't know, I'm an author as well. So Namibia, I think I want to add you in my list. Yes, because the other countries, I don't have that much of connections to get into them, right? But if it was possible, I'll go to UK. So Namibians, I'm seeing you in my comment section below. Hey, I see you guys are commenting and specifically saying, Namibia, Namibia, Namibia. Welcome to South Africa, Namibia. You know what I'm saying? Nevertheless, let's continue. People from Namibia, they will cook us some nice food. I will visit them. I pledge I'll visit you guys. Okay. Now, Mthokozi Sige continued to say some quite interesting things as well. He says that I was skeptical about being there because, like I mentioned earlier, it wasn't a good look for me to be at Senzo Meyiwa's girlfriend house when I was already a very close friend with a fiance Mandisa. In the end of my biggest fear, it came true anyway. Right. So that is where now I also have a problem with Ulomchitalo. Lomchitalo. Hey, go shushu, go nice. Hey, there's something that needs to be said about Mthokozi. Yeah, sometimes I don't know whether it is because maybe we are in a wrong company or what, but yeah, Mthokozi states here categorically clear that He was in the wrong company because he was a friend to Mandisa. He says he's still a friend to Mandisa. Mandisa, ex-wife or fiance, Senzo Meyiwa, right? No problem. Now, you're still friend. I'm asking myself this question. If it was me, and I know that you lied, you know why I know that you lied?
Senzo was shot by Ulongwe Tswala.
Listen.
A call was made by Tumelo. The first call when Senzo was shot was to Tumelo, a boyfriend, Kazandi, of which he didn't know by name, a shot Senzo, and then a phone was dropped. At the background, Ukeli, she was crying. Go down to
the... I know that you're lying because you are not telling the truth. How am I, or how is it that am I your friend, but I know that you are lying? Is that friendship really a good friendship, or it is actually one-sided friendship? The other one is a friend of somebody, and the other one is not a friend of somebody. I don't know if you're seeing what I'm seeing there, but that leaves a lot to be desired. So I was looking at it, I'm like, okay, here, Icon. Let's look at what he said as well. He continues to say, now listen, when Longa Twala stood up, he ran towards the intruder with a gun, pushed him outside and ran past. When I saw everybody getting on their feet from their seats, I saw Senzo Meyiwa in the scuffle with the intruder carrying a firearm. Right, no problem. So Senzo Meyiwa was that brave, eh? Senzo Meyiwa was brave. I'm telling you, Senzo Meyiwa was brave. But okay, let's leave Senzo Meyiwa. Again. Do you want me to give you a proof? This man, Mtokozo Sisulu, one suspect having a knife, the other one having a gun. Longa Twala saw this suspect, two suspects. One having a gun, the other one having a what? A knife. The question is, remember that these people were drunk.
Gunmen actually came in and requested phones and money from us. I was actually the first to stand up to try and protect everyone. I wanted to go get help, but it was late. Neighbors and everyone was sleeping. I didn't even have my phone because I left it at the house, so I couldn't call the cops. A fight broke loose inside because obviously Senzo was protecting Kelly, because the guys were handling Kelly, and then that's when the guys actually released the gunshot, and then that's when the bullet killed Senzo.
So two guys come into the house, they're armed, you're not even carrying a knife or anything, or not even any weapon to defend yourself. You try to push one of them and run out of the house, and they're not even following you to check whether you're going there to your car to fetch a gun to come and shoot at them. Longa said, but when Senzo was actually shot, I was not even inside the room, I ran out. It all happened when I was already out of the room. He was not in the house. How did he see that Senzo died trying to save Kelly?
Have you been interacting with the police? Have they called you?
Yes, we've been investigated by police. They took our phones. I went in for questioning and everything.
Which phones?
Our personal cell phones.
Oh, okay.
Yes, just
they did. They hadn't taken them from you.
They took them from us, and then
the criminals. I mean.
No.
Okay.
They couldn't take my phone because I ran out. I had my phone in my pocket, so they didn't take my phone. But it was late.
Are you beginning to see something here? Who's telling the truth and who's not telling the truth? Longa saw two men with two guns, right? Two men with two guns. Zandikumala saw two men, one with a gun, one with a knife. Ntozisi saw two men, one with a gun, one with a knife. Longwe, remember that it is the Longwe, according to Zandikumala, that went and pushed this guy like a, you know, scrum. I saw in my comment section below, there are people from Cape Town. There's this guy from Cape Town. I saw in my comment section below. He will attest to this, that, you know, how you push a scrum. Maybe he knows, you know what I'm saying, how you push a scrum. So Zandikumala tells us that he tells us that Longa Twala pushed this guy and pushed him like a scrum. Longa Twala tells us that no, there was a second knife. Now, remember that Longa Twala left the house, right?
So he left the two. When he ran away from the house, he left the house with two intruders. He left the house with all the other people and the two intruders. Now, Longa Twala had a physical interaction with these people, right? And the family also had a physical interaction with these people, right? So Longa Twala saw two guns, same house, same day, same minute. He saw two guys with two guns, same day, same house, same people. They saw two people, one with the gun and one with the knife. I'm submitting to you, I put it to you, that the father of Senzo Mehiwa, when he says Tumelo made a call to him and Tumelo told him what had happened, I believe that story than all the bullshit that were being told by these people.
Kumele engabe abopha uLongwe Twala for killing uSenzo. Senzo was shot by uLongwe Twala. There was no one who entered the house. Bese ebopha all these police who had defeated the ends of justice. USenzo was shot by uLongwe Twala.
Listen.
A call was made.
And I'm glad. Mtokozo is cracking. As of me recording this video, I recorded this video today during the cross examination because yesterday I had a problem with my wife and my wife wasn't working at all. It only started working around 9 p.m. From probably around 6 until 9 p.m. That's when it started working. So I couldn't do anything. Look, I had to do a lot of catch up into yesterday's testimony by Mtokozo. After this catch up, then it is now that I got a chance to do this video, right? So as of now, I'm glad it's cracking very easily. It's cracking very 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 easily during the cross examination. I know Ramasipile, give this advocate credit. Give credit when it's due. This guy is cracking Mtokozo so easily. It's not even a struggle. It's not even a match. It's just cracking him so smart, so simple, straightforward. So right now we're gonna get into the cross examination. After this video, the next video that is gonna come up, it is the cross examination. But the cross examination, wow. Give credit to advocate Ramasipile. He's doing an incredible job. Wait a minute. So you and I will meet in that next video. But until then, please take care.